Hello and welcome to episode 49 of Option LU. I'm Lenore.
And I'm Dele.
In this episode, we'll check in with Big Backyard, exit interviews, student spotlight,
big man, and of course, lastly, your champion connection.
It's all coming at you right now.
Places to check out in Lynchburg, Sarah Wells of the Big Backyard has got you covered.
One of Lynchburg's best-kept secrets is a restaurant in downtown called Market at Main, which offers an antique lunch counter style, offering everything from home-style dinners, endless brunch options, and a specialty items market.
3 years ago, I was talking to my landlord, Chopper, who's kind of character downtown, and we had talked about different things that would fit in here and do well. And one of the things I felt, you know, was really missing downtown was the old-style diners that used to be. So we really wanted to bring that feel back of what used to be downtown and kind of make it a comfort place that it was that people enjoyed going. And last year, we were named Best New Small Business of the Year in Lynchburg. And, you know, I would like to think it was because we have great food. We really, really concentrate on customer service. And then I think the atmosphere adds to it. Like I said, we really worked hard to bring back the Woolworths feel, make it a real comfortable place to come, sit, you know, eat, but also to sort of feel like you've stepped back in time a little bit. Yeah, I tell people that almost anything with a fried green tomato on, it's good. And we also have a fried green tomato sandwich and a fried green tomato BLT. And then we were recently awarded the Reader's Choice Award for the News in Advance as having the best hamburger in Lynchburg. So we're very proud of that. And we do a lot of variations of Eggs Benedict, one that instead of the Canadian bacon has our house-made crab cakes, which are really good. We do one with a fried green tomato instead of the Canadian bacon. That's probably one of the favorites down here. A note of appreciation to how much the Liberty University community means to us. Their support is just great.
Oh, wow. And one of the greatest things about Market at Main is the great food, of course, and the wonderful atmosphere. It's a great atmosphere. It's a energized but yet laid back at the same time atmosphere. Depends on what time of day you come. And so this is my spot.
Store hours are Monday and Tuesday, 7 to 2, Wednesday through Saturday, 7 to 9, and Sunday, 8 to 3. So come check out Market at Main today. I'm Sarah Wells for Option LU.
Wow, Dele, I can't believe it's almost the end of the semester. I mean, finals are just around the corner, and Christmas break is 2 weeks away.
That's crazy. I remember the beginning of the semester when we started hosting, and now it's almost over. Wow, it's just it's crazy.
Here's an exit interview with our very own Brittany Tedder.
My name's Brittany Tedder. I've been in Option LU for about a year and a half now, and I'm the host of the sports segment. Option LU is a great tool that we have here at Liberty. It's a show that's for students, by students, about students. It really gives us the opportunity to practice our skills. We get to go out and interview people, and we get to do things that's really real-world experience that you're not going to get anywhere else. With Option LU, I've learned definitely a lot about making deadlines and making sure you get your stuff done on time. With that comes planning things in advance and making sure that you know what you're going to say. I've also learned a lot about toning my skills and practicing my pronunciation and being excited about what I do. Technically, learning editing stuff has really been really beneficial. It's been great learning the different softwares like Final Cut and Avid and things like that. I would tell any student who's interested in any aspect of TV production to definitely take Option LU. It teaches you real world experience. When I went on my internship, the stuff I learned from Option LU was exactly the stuff that I saw in an actual newsroom in the real world. So it's definitely a very good replica for that. So any student who's interested in any kind of TV should definitely take Option LU.
That's it for Option LU Sports this semester. I'm Brittany Tedder.
And I'm Robbie Vogler. We'll see you next semester.
Merry Christmas!
No. Next up is Student Spotlight, and this week it's on Tabitha Costner.
Have you ever experienced brokenness? And if you had, did this brokenness reveal God's will for you? Tabitha Costner, who's the shooter for Student Spotlight, has a story to tell. Stay tuned.
So I grew up in a Christian home to where Christ was always the center of everything, and church was very important to us. And it wasn't until I was about 7 years old, I remember being home late one night with my dad, sick from church, and just asking him, you know, like, Dad, what does it mean to go to heaven? What does it mean to have a personal relationship with Christ? And I remember at that moment, he led me through the plan of salvation. And so at 7 years old, I was just like, you know, what seven-year-old wouldn't want to go to heaven? So I just said the prayer, and I was really excited about it, and I went on living my life the way I had had before. At this point in my life, when I was about 11 years old, I remember doing a Bible study one night with my mom, and my mom was, you know, she saw me crying. She was, you know, like, what's wrong? Like, she was really concerned, and I remember just, you know, like, just breaking down and really just telling my mom, you know, I don't think that I'm saved. I don't feel like I gave my life fully to Christ. I feel like that was just a prayer that I prayed at 7 years old. And so with that, for about 30 minutes, I remember just wrestling back and forth, this spiritual warfare that I had never felt before and that I had never dealt with before. And at that moment, I just completely just broke down and finally gave my heart and my life to Christ. And so it wasn't until until I was about 20 years old, which is about 2 years ago, a situation took place in my life that left me completely broken. And it was a place that I had never been before. It was a place that that I felt like I was on this road, and I was on this place that I had never thought would ever exist in my life, or I never thought would ever take place. And when I was finally at this crossroads, I remember, because of my feelings of abandonment and feeling alone, I ran away from the one that I should have been running to, and that was Christ. The things that I felt like were important in my life, and that I had made before Him, and that I had made enough in my life, and that I had used to fill me, other than using Him to fill me, God allowed these things to finally be stripped away. And this one thing that I had in my life that I so valued and that I so appreciated and that I so loved, I was so angry and so mad at God for allowing this to take place. And it wasn't until this summer that I realized that I had two choices, that I could either let this situation break me, or that I could allow God to use the situation through my brokenness to prepare me for the plan that He had for my life. And up until this point, I had always had this huge plan of going into Christian filmmaking, and I wanted to make Christian movies because I felt like our culture did not have enough of that. And so through that, God's really been laying missions on my heart, because I've realized that those missionaries who have gone before into other countries and other cultures, and who have witnessed to those thousands and hundreds, and those thousands and hundreds have gotten saved, yet what do they do and what are they left with after those missionaries leave? And I really feel like that this is where my passion comes in with filmmaking, that I would like to make films that provide the resources for those individuals to help them grow in their walk with Christ.
Well, thank you guys for watching part one of episode 49.
If you want to watch your big man and your champion connection, stick around.
Now, welcome back to part two of episode 49. Now, look, I still don't get it. The big man called me last time. I mean, it's not a privilege because no one actually calls me.
Dele, stop talking about it.
The big man called me. You guys don't get it.
Oh. Anyways, here's a recap of the big man on campus.
Hey guys, it's Big Man. You know, it's been a great semester. We've done lots of things. I want to stop by the Rot and check in with you and see how everything has went this semester. Let's go check it out. What's been the favorite part of your semester?
My semester? Being a prayer leader. Leadership on my hall.
What's been the best part of your semester?
Paintball. Paintball team.
Probably sports events.
Football games are pretty awesome. Football games are good.
What's been your favorite part of the semester?
Favorite part of the semester, just the guys in the dorm. They're all really good guys.
Just dancing for Jesus, going crazy all the time. That's my favorite part of the semester.
What's been the worst part of your semester?
Worst part of my semester has been exercise science 311.
Having to get my senior honors thesis proposal ready.
What's been the toughest part of your semester?
School, just schoolwork.
This class right here. I carry this book everywhere I go.
Lots of papers.
Big ones, small ones?
couple 10-page papers.
Worst thing, I don't know. My favorite, though, I met her. She's really nice.
We just talked to all these other people, guys, and, you know, sort of recap their semester of what their favorite and worst part is. Well, now it's time for the big man to tell you what his favorite and worst part is. My favorite part has been being the big man. But the not-so-favorite part now is that I have to sign off as big man. This is my last episode as big man, so I want you to stay tuned for next season and see who the new big man is. So I'm big man, and we'll see you next time.
Do you want to know what's going on around campus?
Oh, stay tuned for your Chapman Connection.
Hello everyone, I'm Mike Johansson, and this is the Champion Connection. Student loan debt is quickly approaching $1 trillion in the United States, and it's projected to surpass that amount by the end of 2011. To help combat expenses, Liberty University will be offering an assortment of classes in a number of departments this summer at a discounted rate of $310 per credit hour. That's a $300 savings when compared to fall and spring tuition prices. In addition to the cheaper tuition, summer classes will help students stay on track to graduate on time or allow them to graduate early. There will be 2 4-week sessions this summer, with the first session starting May 14th and ending June 8th, and the second session beginning June 11th and ending July 16th. Students enrolled in the summer school program will have the option of staying on campus on the resident halls if they so desire. Online registration begins January 30th. And now here's Tahesha Moist reporting on the Forge Conference.
Hey everyone, right now I'm at the Forge 2011 Youth Leadership Conference hosted by one of Liberty University's organizations called Band of Leaders, who I introduced you all to a couple months ago.
This past November 11th and 12th, Band of Leaders hosted a Youth Leadership Summit called Forge 2011. It was two nights of power-packed ministry and intimate worship where the young people learned how to make an impact for God. The nights started off with worship led by Lorenzo Jackson. In addition, a group of girls worshiped the Lord using dance. On Friday, evangelist Chris Palmer spoke to the youth, and on Saturday, Ray McQueen, pastor of Family Life Christian Church International, challenged the youth and gave them some insight.
Great leadership doesn't start 5 years down the road. It starts right where you are now. You're here to make an impact. You're here to make a change, but you got to stop looking at yourself.
But before the night ended, I was able to speak to the founder of Band of Leaders.
In Band of Leaders, our number one challenge and our number one goal is to build God-made leaders. And that's really what Forge is about. We're about building God-made leaders and really encouraging them to infiltrate their society. But I believe no one has a special place in the heart of young people. As young people, I believe we can reach them where they are. We say, fired up, ready to go. That's it, right there.
Now, if you'd like to join Band of Leaders' quest to change the world in terms of leadership, or if you'd like more information about them, check out their website at www.bandofleaders.com or check out their Facebook group at facebook.com/bandofleaders. Reporting for the Champion Connection, I'm Tahesha Moise.
Thank you, Tahesha. Liberty University is partnering with the Operation Christmas Child for the fourth year in a row, collecting shoeboxes filled with small gifts and necessities for impoverished children around the world. Last year, Liberty donated more than 1,100 shoebox gifts. The drop-off deadline has passed, but Liberty student Jamie McDonald hopes to create interest early for creating a team that will actually travel to deliver the packages next year. For more information on that, you can contact Jamie at jlmcdonald2@liberty.edu. Are you interested in learning to snowboard? Here's Hannah Elliott on some lessons being offered at the Liberty Mountain Snowflex.
Hey guys, it's that time of the year again. It's almost Christmas, and you know what that means. It's time to hang up the hiking shoes and pull out the snowboarding or skiing boots. Don't know how to ski or snowboard, you say? Well, Snowflex offers lessons in both skiing and snowboarding. I'm here to get my very first snowboarding lesson. We are here up at Snowflakes with Zach Buckle, a snowboarding instructor. So Zach, what's the first thing a student has to do to get a snowboard checked out?
First thing you're going to need to do if you want to get a snowboard checked out, as soon as you walk in, you're going to want to go get on the computers. There's going to be three of them as soon as you walk in. And you're going to want to get in, fill out your information, and you'll be able to go to the front desk and check out a snowboard. If you're looking for more information, you can check out our Facebook page. It's on Facebook, Liberty Snowflex. Look that up. That can give you that lets you know our hours of operation, what events are coming up, what's going on, or you can just stop on up.
Okay. All right, reporting for the Champion Connection, this is Hannah Elliott.
Thank you, Hannah. Well, that does it for another edition of the Champion Connection. Make sure to pick up your free copy of the Liberty Champion or check them out online at libertychampion.com. Now back to Lenore and Dele.
Well, that's it for this week's episode of Option LU. And as always, don't forget to check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/OptionLU.
And on Twitter at Option LU. See you next time.